for the Tar Heels.
If Michael Jordan had decided to stay for his senior year, but another great coaching job by Dean Smith, Wolf, Hunter, Doherty, the leading scorer and rebounder, a junior, Steve Hale and Kenny Smith, a sharp shooting backcourt for Carolina. Duke, ranked fifth in the nation, 21-5, all five losses in the conference. Ellery Maher from Canada, Billis, Amaker, and Dawkins, a very talented starting five.
Joe Forte is our referee. The umpires are Tom Frame and Hank Nichols. Carolina in its road blue will be going to the west goal in the first half. Duke in its home white to the east goal. We're underway. Delighted you're with us. Tap control by Duke. Billis tapped it a couple of times to get it to Ellery. He drops it to Amaker, and it's to Dawkins. And Carolina will open in a man-to-man defense. Hale on Dawkins. Kenny Smith got the defensive assignment on Amaker. Ellery playing well out. We'll have Joe Wolf on him. Dawkins jump shot. It's 2-0 Duke. From the right side, Johnny Dawkins, the Blue Devils' leading point maker at 18-2, sends Duke ahead in the first 20 seconds of play. Duke also has opened in a man-to-man defense. Smith away to Hunter. Low to Wolf. Wolf with a jump hook. No good. They crash the boards, and it was Villas outfighting Maher for the rebound. Bounce pass away to Dawkins, right through the Royal Blue Center jump circle here at ancient Cameron Indoor Stadium. Comes Dawkins, gives it to Amaker. He's calling out the offense. He had only four turnovers in his last seven games, but got five on Wednesday night against Clemson. He's still got only 57 for the year. Here's Dawkins pushing it back to Billis. Intercepted Smith. They go to the floor, and the foul's on Johnny Dawkins for kicking unintentionally, of course, Kenny Smith. So Dawkins, who today starts his 88th consecutive game for the Blue Devils, gets his team its first foul of the game.
Duke is picking up on something Georgia Tech did, screening out Steve Hale with their best shooter while he's guarding their best shooter. That's something Georgia Tech was doing with Mark Price as well.
Kenny Smith spins away from Amaker, drives the lane. Short jumper is good, but there's a foul called on Amaker. And I'll tell you, between the two of them, Tommy Amaker and Kenny Smith, there was an awful lot of shoving going on. Kenny Smith got away with a push off his left elbow as he was starting the drive in the lane, and Amaker gets whistled for his first personal foul, second team foul. Kenny Smith tied it and will have a chance for the three-point play.
Absolutely right. It could have gone either way, Woody. I'm looking for a physical ball game here.
No, there will be no free throw on the play. The foul came before the shot, so the score remains tied at 2-2. Carolina just has possession of the ball. Wolf at the left wing against a tightly guarding Jay Billis. Joe Wolf gets it to Steve Hale, lobs inside to Brad Doherty. Up shot, no good. Tap follow, no good. Another tap, and then Doherty controls, and it's 4-2. Now they have gone back and taken away the basket by Kenny Smith, but it is tied now at 2-2 on Brad Doherty's follow. So the foul a moment ago against Tommy Amaker coming before the shot. That's why it was not a three-point play, and that's why the goal got taken away. Dawkins shoots over Steve Hale, and Hale is called for the bump. And I'll tell you, at the very outset of this ball game, Henry Hinton, if this game is called this tight the rest of the way, I should have brought a bag supper with me. We may be here a long, long time.
Again, it was coming across the lane. Johnny Dawkins was moving across, and Steve Hale picking up a little screen, having to fight off the screen to get back at Johnny Dawkins. And when he finally got there, he did give him a little nudge, and he was in the act of shooting. But they're doing a good job of keeping Steve Hale away from him as Dawkins makes his first one.
Dawkins has all three of the Duke points now in a 3-2 Duke lead over Carolina in the first minute and 33 seconds from Durham. He'll have a chance to make it 4-2 and does. Dawkins, the fourth best free throw shooter in the league at 80.3%, makes it 4-2 in favor of Duke. Kenny Smith on the left-hand dribble, picked up by Tommy Amaker at the timeline, moving right, taken away by Amaker. He'll get the easy basket. Great steal by Tommy Amaker, and it's 6-2 in favor of Duke. That's Amaker's 42nd steal of the season. Curtis Hunter double team backcourt, and he's fouled by Dan Maher. Well, Maher picks up his first foul. Duke had gone to the three-quarter court zone pressure, and they double teamed Hunter in the backcourt just short of the timeline. Three team fouls already against Duke. Carolina will get the ball out of bounds just inside the backcourt, right in front of the scorer's table. Joe Wolf inbound the ball, gets it to Brad Doherty. Brad, high lob to Wolf, down the left sideline, not quite to the hash mark. Now his double takes it down the left sideline, picks it up now, and it's knocked away by Dawkins and recovered by Billis. Two turnovers, Carolina. Duke's quick hands causing Carolina problems here in the early going. Bounce pass inside intended for Maher, kicked away by Hale. And Steve again has got what looks like a football thigh pad. It's not quite that heavy, really, but he's got a thigh pad taped to the outside of his right thigh. So that's the thigh that's been bothering him. And as I told you prior to the start of the game, He got it injured again on Wednesday night in Atlanta. Amaker pushes it away to Dawkins. 6-2 in favor of Duke. Blue Devils could go up by 6. Mahar, and it's 8-2. Well, the Duke scoring is very balanced. Dawkins 4, Amaker 2, and Mahar 2. Thus far, Brad Daugherty with the only goal for Carolina. Pass away to Hunter against Mahar, and Hunter will drive into the lane. Tried to flip it back, and an offensive foul is called on Hunter. For Mahar, that is the 20th charge he has taken this season, and nobody else on the Duke team is in double figures as far as taking charges, and Mahar delights in it.
Tar Heels need to be a little more patient. Curtis trying to force something that really wasn't there. That lane wasn't open, Woody, and he just forced his way through there and picked up the charge.
He almost lost the ball a moment before his drive. It's 8-2 in favor of the Blue Devils, and Duke could stretch it to 10 if successful on this trip to the east end of Cameron Indoor Stadium. Mahar dumps to Billis at the baseline. 15-foot jumper. No good. Crash the board. Dallery's there. Reverse layup is no good. They crash the boards again. It's loose recovered. Kenny Smith. Smith gets started front court, and Dawkins, very foolish on Johnny's part, reaches in and has picked up his second foul. Fourth team foul. It was evident, and I say foolish, because it was evident that Kenny Smith had a step on Dawkins. Dawkins had no chance to make a clean steal, and he reached in, and he'll have to go to the bench as David Henderson, the junior from Drury, North Carolina, replaces him.
Duke getting a lot of offensive rebounds down there. A lot of guys standing around for Carolina, kind of reminiscent of the way the Georgia Tech game started, Woody.
Here's Wolf back to Steve Hale. Outside jumper is no good, rimmed out. Curtis Hunter with a rebound. Has to get it back outside to Kenny Smith. 20-foot jumper by Smith is short. Nick the rim, recovered. Brad Daugherty at the baseline. Duke has now started to stand around a bit. Here's Hale. Feeds Joe Wolf. Drives baseline. Short jumper. No good. Whistle, and it's an offensive foul on Wolf. And Mahar, in the first 3.5 minutes of play, has taken 2 charges from the Tar Heels, giving him 21 on the year. Well, Lefty Drizel has called him the biggest faker in the league. Danny says, it makes me mad for people to call me a faker. I don't fake until I've been hit several times.
Well, he's going to get the True Blue Award for the fourth year in a row for taking the most charges, and already today he's added 2.
We got a whistle and a foul on Kenny Smith in the midcourt area on the pass from Billis over to Allery. The foul on Smith is his first. That will be the fourth team foul against Carolina. These teams are all even as far as team fouls are concerned. Wolf trying to drive the baseline a moment ago, and Mahar had excellent position. Both feet planted. Inbounds to Allery. One dribble moving left of the lane. Mahar off the baseline, and it's no good. Rebound by Brad Daugherty. Had Billis boxed out nicely. The Curtis Hunter coming front court against Amaker. Drives, lost it over the inline, and it belongs to Duke. Hunter tried to make something happen too quickly, and he was the only guy down floor against 2 Blue Devils.
Well, he put it down on the floor between his legs. Carolina is only 1 of 6 from the floor. Duke is 2 of 4.
Already 5 turnovers for the Tar Heels, according to statistician Bob Woodruff. It's 8-2 Duke. Henderson knocking Hale down. No foul to Billis. Open, 17. Off the front of the rim. Rebounded by Henderson. Lost in the lane. They struggle for it. We got a jump ball, and it'll belong to Carolina on alternating possession. David Henderson for Duke and Steve Hale for Carolina going to the floor. And right now, these teams are going to get a break in the action, and Duke has jumped to an early advantage. That means that Warren Martin, the junior from Axton, Virginia, has replaced Curtis Hunter for Carolina. It's 8-2 in favor of the Blue Devils. Duke will come back with David Henderson still on the floor in place of Johnny Dawkins, who's saddled with 2 personal.
Tar Heels have 5 turnovers, 2, a couple for Joe Wolf, a couple for Steve Hale, I believe.
Kenny Smith across the timeline against Amaker, gets it to Hale along the right wing against David Henderson. Hale tried to go baseline, can't get through, comes to Brad Daugherty, top of the circle. Now to Joe Wolf, to Steve Hale, lobs it inside to Martin. Martin faking, soft shot is up against Allery and good. Warren Martin makes it 8-4 in favor of Duke. Tommy Amaker on the left-hand dribble, right through the center jump circle. Mike Krzyzewski is getting Marty Nestle ready to come into the ball game. Henderson right of the circle to Mahar. Bounce pass inside to Billis. He turns against Martin. Up off the glass, no good. They crash the boards, and I believe they're going to whistle Allery for the foul. Indeed, everything was clogged up inside, and Allery just went flying through trying to get control of the rebound. His first, 5th team foul, and Carolina gets it out of bounds as Marty Nestle, the 7'2 sophomore from Whitehall, Ohio, is in the ball game for Duke.
You might be concerned about the Tar Heels' offensive threat so far with only 4 points in about 5 minutes, but Duke really hadn't been that strong either. They haven't scored a bucket in about 2 minutes now.
Joe Wolf from Kenny Smith on the right side, holding high, needs some help, finally turns against Mahar, drives baseline, bounced it to Daugherty, laid it up off the glass, and it's 8-6. in favor of Duke. So Carolina's cut the six-point Duke advantage down to just two. Amaker across the timeline. Dawkins is back to the table and will come in on the next dead ball. Henderson on the left side. Amaker penetrating. Slapped away Kenny Smith, and Hank Nichols whistles Kenny Smith for the foul. The Queens New York sophomore can't believe it. He thought he got all ball at the peak of Amaker's jump, but it will be foul number two on Kenny Smith. Kenny Smith coming into today's ball game with 200 assists to his credit. He's only 17 shy of wiping out Phil Ford's single season record of 217 set in 1977. And Amaker goes back to the line.
Dean Smith electing to stick with Kenny Smith now, even with two personal fouls this early in the ball game. You know, a lot of times we see Coach Smith take a guy out if he gets two within the first 4 or 5 minutes of the ball game. Now Kenny's got two within the first 6 minutes.
Free throw by Amaker was no good. He shoots 76% at the line. Tommy Amaker with only 57 turnovers in 257 minutes of action this season. 8-6 the score, 14-51. Left to play in the half. The next one is good. And so it's a 9-6 ball game. Amaker's going out. Dawkins is in. Duke will have Nestle, Allery, Mahar, Henderson, and Dawkins. Carolina has Hale, Wolf, Daugherty, Smith, and Martin in the lineup. Kenny Smith has got to play carefully now, just as Dawkins has, to keep from getting three here in the first half. Lob to Martin. He turns baseline between the double team. Puts it back out front to Smith. Over to Hale. Hale with a faking. Henderson got on him. Goes baseline. Can't get through. Puts it across the top of the defense to Joe Wolf on the left side. Wolf driving down. Breaks his dribble. Comes to Hale. Now over to Warren Martin. Martin shooting over Nestle. Got it. And it's 9-8. Warren Martin come off the bench to get four. He had 16 points, 10 rebounds in the first meeting between these two teams back on January the 19th. 14-15, left to play in the first half. Henderson pushes it away to Dawkins. Carolina in the 1-3-1 matchup zone now. Mahar to Henderson on the left side. Back on the right to Dawkins at the top of the circle. Johnny into the top of the circle, one step. Drops it to Henderson. Tried to get it to Allery. Knocked away. Recovered Wolf. Long outlet to Hale. Hale on the drive. Laid it up. And Carolina leads for the first time at 10-9. Steve Hale with his first field goal of the ball game. The Duke crowd throwing up some rather clever signs during the timeout. I'll tell you about them later. Tries to muster enough to get back in it, but has grown strangely quiet. Allery's shot from outside is no good. Wolf with a rebound. Quick outlet to Hale on the right side. Coming down against Dawkins. Breaks his dribble. Slippery spot. Crowd thought he walked with it. No call by Nichols, who was right on top of the play. To Martin. He turns on Nestle. Can't get through at the baseline. Comes back outside to Smith from 20 feet. Will not go down. Henderson had the rebound. Nice rebound by Henderson of Durham, North Carolina. Took it down in between the two bigger guys, Warren Martin and Joe Wolf. 10-9 Carolina with 13-15 left in the half. Henderson from outside, rimmed out. Joe Wolf with a rebound. High lob to Hale. Whips it to Smith with Henderson on him. Dawkins picks up Smith. Kenny backs to the right wing. Now he will keep his dribble alive. Comes top of the circle. Gets it to Joe Wolf. Wolf against Mahar. Can't get through. Hale open. 18 feet. Jumper good. And it's 12-9 in favor of Carolina on Steve Hale's first second field goal of the ball game. Pete Godet, the former Army assistant and later head coach after Mike Krzyzewski left, who's in his second year at Duke, gets up and says something to his boss, who's kneeling right in front of the Duke bench. High post pass comes to Allery. Looked low, has to go back out front to Mahar. Now to Dawkins with 12:40 to play in the half. Dawkins directing a little traffic. Wants Mahar over on the left side. Mahar takes the pass, couple of dribbles. He needs some help. Got to get rid of it against Daugherty. Gets it out to Dawkins near the hash mark on the left sideline. Dawkins pounding the ball to the floor with his left hand. Picks up his dribble, comes to Mahar, top of the circle. Looked inside to Nestle, couldn't get it to him. Now Henderson pushes it inside to Nestle. Nestle right of the lane, knocked away. Fouls on Warren Martin. It's his first 15 foul, Carolina.
Well, Warren Martin's done quite a job since he's been in the ball game. Brad Daugherty's going to come out now. Dave Potts is returning for Carolina. But when Warren came in the game, Carolina was down 8-2 at the 15:57 mark. He's picked up a couple of buckets, also one assist, I believe, and has done a very good job of kind of spurring Carolina onto a little offensive threat here.
Substitutions now for Carolina. Curtis Hunter is back. David Popson and Buzz Peterson appear for the first time as Hale, Daugherty, and Wolf all go out. Duke comes back now with Kevin Strickland and Billy King for the first time, and also back in is Jay Billis. Duke inbounds the ball to Henderson. Henderson dribbled the ball on the out-of-bounds line, but Joe Forte, looking up top, did not see it. And so it's going to still be Duke's ball as Henderson bounced it out-of-bounds off for a couple of Tar Heel defenders. But he dribbled the ball squarely on the end line. Pass over in the corner to Strickland out of the corner. No good. Smith taps the rebound. Strickland has it. Lost to Billis. Billis spins in the lane. Puts it up. No good. They battled. Billis has still got it. Up again. Good. 12-11. Jay Billis just got that one with second effort. Under 12 minutes to play in the half. Carolina with a one-point lead. Kenny Smith trying to get front court. Brad Daugherty up ready to come back. Curtis Hunter deep in the right corner over to Buzz Peterson, who works against Kevin Strickland. He drives right of the circle, can't get through, drops it to Popson, jump shot, 17, flat but good. Dave Popson with his first field goal, 14-11. Carolina by three with 11:35 to play in the first half. Dawkins across the top of the circle, comes out to Strickland, down the right sideline. Strickland comes back to the hash mark, drops it to Dawkins. Carolina in the zone now, 2-3, bounce pass to Henderson, fighting through traffic, lost it, recovered, puts it away to Billis. He's open, shot left corner, no good. Knocked around, and Henderson went over Popson's back. Popson had him boxed out nicely. Henderson picks up his first. That's the sixth team foul, and I think there's going to be an official timeout coming at Cameron Indoor Stadium. There is indeed. 11:20 showing on the first half clock, and with timeout on the floor. The score, Carolina 14, Duke 11.
That's for the Blue Devils. That's 29%, Woody, in about 9 minutes of play here.
Henry, what makes that particularly interesting is on Wednesday night against Clemson, the regulars went out of that game, and at the time, the first unit of Duke was shooting 79% in the ball game.
Well, a little bit of a different situation here today. Carolina, by the way, hit only one of their first six shots. Since then, have hit five of six. They're 7 of 13 for the game, over 50% at 54.
Brad Daugherty's in replacing Warren Martin as Carolina has possession and the lead, 14-11. Push pass to Buzz Peterson. Now to Joe Wolf with David Henderson up in his face on the right sideline. Wolf comes top of the circle. Popson from 20 feet. Can't get the bounce. It's off the front of the rim. Rebounded by Henderson off to Dawkins. Duke quickly front court. Duke trying to pick up the pace of the game. Henderson had a notion. Can't work baseline against Daugherty. Now has to pick up his dribble. Back out front to Dawkins. 10:50 left to play in the first half. 14-11 Carolina. Amaker against Buzz Peterson. Peterson stuck a hand in without drawing the foul. Strickland now to Dawkins. Dawkins gives it right back to Strickland, top of the circle. Kevin into the circle, one step, then back to Dawkins. Drops to Dallery from 20 feet. Will not go, and Buzz Peterson with a good box out by everybody in the lane flies through the air to pull the rebound down. He works left side, whips it to Daugherty, goes to Joe Wolf. Wolf moves in on Strickland, off the glass, no good, and Strickland draws the foul.
All Strickland could do was foul him. He really lost Joe Wolf across the lane underneath. Joe did a good job of getting away, moving without the ball, but to be honest with you, Strickland was just kind of in the ozone there for a minute, lost his man, and Carolina is lucky, or rather Duke's lucky, that's not a three-point play instead of just the two free throws.
Kevin Strickland out of North Surrey High School near Mount Airy, who was the Northwest North Carolina Player of the Year in both 83 and 84, gets his first. It's the team's seventh. Wolf is going to shoot two anyway for Carolina. Joe shooting 74% at the line. Didn't play in the first meeting between these two teams. That was during the period he was out six games with the ankle problem. That's his first point of the game. He came in averaging 9.1 points a ball game and nearly five rebounds.
Woody, the Duke guys inside aren't doing too good. Mark Allery's 0 of 3, and Jay Billis has only hit 1 of 5 shots.
Wolf makes it 16-11. Carolina with its biggest lead of the half, 5 points with 10:23 showing on the overhanging clock. Dawkins across the timeline against Hale, comes top of the circle, breaks his dribble, goes to Henderson on the left side. Henderson driving baseline, double team, can't get through. Pass right side to Dawkins. Left-handed jumper is up, rattled in, popped out, and fell back through. Dawkins with 6 points, but his first points in a while. 16-13, inside pass to Popson, knocked away Dawkins, and he steps on the end line. Duke fans don't agree in that west end zone. McConnell frame on top of the play, and Mike Krzyzewski coming off the Duke bench right to the edge of the playing floor, as Henry points out, is voicing his displeasure as well. Now Mahar is back in, and Henderson is coming out. Strickland has also come out of the lineup, and let's see who else has gone back in. Amaker, yes. Daugherty will inbound from the baseline, 16-13, with 10 minutes to play in the first half. Got it to Hale at the left wing. He comes against Amaker, spinning away. Ball knocked loose, and Amaker draws his foul, second foul, and he can't believe it. He was taking the ball away. He got it cleanly first, and then when Hale went back to get it, that's when Amaker bumped him, and I think that was the call by Tom Frame. Anyway, it's being questioned right now by Mike Krzyzewski. Well, looks like he got it cleanly the first time, Henry, don't you think?
Looked like it might have been, but Woody, it points out to something that Dean Smith has said in the pregame show today, and that is the fact that Carolina just really isn't taking very good care of the ball. Already today we've seen a couple of steals that you might not have seen earlier in the season. Maybe a little lackluster ball handling.
Hale's free throw is up and good. That's 5 points for Steve Hale. He's hit his last 15 free throws in a row. He's shooting 88% at the line on the year to lead the ACC. 17-13 the score. The next one's good as well, and it's 18-13. Hale with 6. Leads the Carolina scoring. Heels will put on pressure now in the backcourt. Not real heavy, just enough to let the Blue Devils know they're there, but Dawkins is not impeded coming front court. 9:50 to play in the half. Dawkins along the right wing to Allery, top of the circle, and we get a whistle and a holding. Yeah, called on Popson inside.
Good call by Dave Popson. Just a little bit too aggressive inside. Danny Mahar was trying to jockey for position down on the low post. and Thompson just really just hooked him around and kind of held him from the front.
I was telling you about some of the signs a moment ago in Cameron Indoor Stadium. One during halftime said, hands off the clock, Dean, making reference to a year ago when Coach Smith had trouble getting players into the game at the scorer's table. And one student I know put up the sign that said, hey, Dean, nobody beats Coach K. Well, that fella brought that sign today because he couldn't bring it to the state games this year. Mahar's at the free throw line. He'll shoot two shots. This is the free throw. Or one and one, actually. Beg your pardon, it was a one and one situation on Carolina's seventh team foul. He missed it, and it's 18 to 13 as Carolina comes away with it. Martin had the rebound. Hale, now to Martin, just left of the lane against Billis. Feeds it back out to Smith. Crowd thought he walked. Smith off the right wing against Dawkins. Now it comes to Wolf. Kenny Smith has yet to score in the game. Had an early goal taken away. Here's Joe Wolf trying to drop it to Martin. Good catch of the ball at the baseline. Moves in. Fake. Lays it up and it's good. Against Jay Billis. Well, the crowd is hollering that Martin is walking all over the place.
I'm not
it's
sure.
20-13.
He may have taken one little step in there somewhere, Woody. That was a lot of faking going on.
9:05 left to play in the first half. Dawkins away to Amaker. Top of the circle. Comes back to Dawkins. Billis, Dawkins, Amaker, top of the circle. Left side, they move it now to Allery. Drops it to Amaker. Carolina packed back in the 2-3 zone. Foul line to baseline. Amaker to Allery. Jump shot over the zone. An air ball. Rebounded Billis. He lays it up and scores. Jay Billis recovered the air ball of Mark Allery and gets his second field goal. 20-15 Carolina. 8:40 to play in the first half. Kenny Smith going left. Now turning right. Drops it to Joe Wolf. Mahar moving out on him. Wolf holds high. Got to get rid of it. Finally puts it to the floor to get a new count. Now drops it to Martin, who brings Allery well out into the midcourt area. Martin holding high. Now he goes to the floor inside the hash mark. Spinning away. Almost lost it in a double dribble. Hank Nichols whistles on Warren Martin. Johnny Dawkins, the smaller of the two, helps the gangly Martin to his feet. 20-15, and Dean Smith is telling Warren Martin something now specifically as he jabs the air with his left hand.
I don't think he wanted Warren to do a reverse dribble into the lane like that.
I think when Coach Smith jabs the air with his left hand, that is underlining what he's saying. 20-15, and I believe it may have been something to the effect, Warren, don't you do that again. Amaker, top of the circle to Dawkins. Long outside jump, and gets within three. 20-17. Dawkins with eight. He came into the game needing just 11 to move into ninth place on Duke's all-time scoring list. Daugherty getting back into the Carolina lineup now. Heels inbounded. Martin to Smith. It is Warren Martin, Brad Daugherty, Joe Wolf, Steve Hale, and Kenny Smith. The big lineup, if you will, for Carolina. For Duke, Dawkins, Amaker, Mahar, Billis, and Allery. Long cross-court pass to Martin. Gets it right back to Hale. Jump shot from out on the right is no good. Rebounded by Dawkins. Got it under control. Duke with a chance to get within one. Dawkins on the drive, and it's good. Kenny Smith stood there to take the charge, but he didn't step in very boldly. And Dawkins managed to go right by him for a 20-19 Carolina lead. Been chopped from five down to, or seven rather, down to just one.
I think Kenny was thinking about that third foul possibly there, would he?
Daugherty against Allery gives it to Hale. Good, tight man-to-man defense by Duke. You heard Mike Krzyzewski say, top of the show, this is the way Duke does is with its feet. And Warren Martin gets it low and banks it off the glass from the low post. Martin, who was very ineffective against Georgia Tech with only 2 points, three rebounds, and a 1-for-4 performance, has come off the bench here this afternoon to go 4-for-4 from the floor, 22-19 Carolina. Inside, Billis moves on Daugherty, muscles his way, knocked down, ball knocked out of bounds, off Steve Hale, says Hank Nichols. Dean Smith jumped up. He wanted the foul on Billis for flattening Brad Daugherty in the lane. Didn't get it. What we will get right now is an official timeout. 6:59 left to play in the first half. Timeout on the floor. The score, Carolina 22.
Carolina up by three, 22-19. Kind of a strange tempo to the ball game. It's been rather slow, but Warren Martin has clearly been the turning point. He came in at the 8-2. 8-2 is the score. Duke had an 6-point lead, rather. That was at the 15:57 mark. Since that time, Warren has scored eight of Carolina's 17 points since that point of the ballgame. The Tar Heels are now 9 of 17, 53%. Duke, 8 of 21, 38%. Where's Mark Allery? What, he didn't show up today.
Dawkins flying through the air, banks it off the glass. It's no good, and Brad Daugherty's got the rebound. Dawkins, Duke's point leader with 10. Martin leads Carolina with 8. Long front court pass to Wolf, coming down the left side from Smith. Back to Brad Daugherty. Open 17. Jumper's good. 24-19. Carolina once ahead by 7. Back up now by 5 on Brad Daugherty's 6 points. Amaker looking to the Duke benches across the timeline, working to the right now. Whips the pass down to Mahar. Back it comes to Amaker now. Amaker with Carolina in the zone, gives it back to Mahar. Penetrates, jumpers up off the glass, good. Danny Mahar, one of three Duke seniors, has his second field goal, and it's 24-21. Carolina by three, 6:20 showing on the overhanging clock. Kenny Smith starting left, goes right, hits Wolf. Henderson all over him defensively, flicking at the ball. Comes now to Daugherty, who brings Mahar well out. Brad puts it to the floor, tried to get it to Smith, stolen Amaker. Kenny will try to cut him off, can't do it, he missed the shot. Amaker didn't put it up strong enough. Here comes Kenny Smith, quickly front court, and Amaker picks his pocket again. Two straight steals by Tommy Amaker. Kenny Smith took a quick look at him as he was coming front court, and then he took his eye off of him, and by golly, there came Amaker to get it right back. 24-21, Carolina by three. Duke can get within two. Johnny Dawkins, cross court to Henderson, deep in the left corner. Henderson puts it to the floor, inside to Mahar, feeds Phyllis, moves underneath, reverse layup, no good. Phyllis recovers and dunks it. Martin knocked down, no foul on the play. Phyllis has his third field goal. Martin is injured, and the crowd loves it because Phyllis flattened Martin and didn't get called for a foul.
Well, now what's happening right now, Phyllis missed the first shot, got his own rebound, came up. Warren had position on him. I'm not sure that Phyllis didn't take his left arm and swipe him away a little bit. Of course, Warren went down to the floor hard. That might have hurt more than the actual contact.
Well, that thud when he fell to the floor jarred his contact loose, knocked it out. Warren's got to come to the bench and try to put that back in, and the Carolina lead is quickly cut to only one at 24-23.
I mentioned a minute ago that Allery was he didn't show up for the game today. He's back in the game now, but Duke has actually got their last two baskets from big men inside, Mahar and Phyllis. But other than that, they really haven't scored any points from the big men inside today. Carolina's done a pretty good job up to now keeping them away.
Buzz Peterson at the left wing, dribbling, now goes left of the lane, will take the short baseline jumper, high arcing shot, no good. Henderson saving it to Allery, falling down, he got it to Amaker. Duke can lead, and Allery's hurt on the play. Amaker with a jump shot, no good. Hunter had it, lost it, Brad Daugherty recovered. Protecting it, and now play is stopped as Allery has gotten up limping. Henry coming into the ball game. Mark Allery, the 6'9 junior from Scottsdale, Arizona, who has a younger brother living out in the Arizona area, who is a victim of CP, cerebral palsy, coming into this ball game today and had scored double figures in 25 of the 26 starts. The only game this year he'd not been in double figures was 8 points at North Carolina State when Wolfpack won going away. He's flexing his ankle. I think he'll be back, but he's going out for a brief rest to let Max Crowder take a look at it.
Wednesday night in the Duke game, Tim Cafferty, our production assistant, told us that he looked a little bit pale, like he might have been sick. There has been a flu bug kind of circulating through the Duke team this week. I'm not too sure that Allery's 100% as far as his health is concerned. He really hadn't been in the flow of this game yet.
Peterson, high lob inside to Daugherty. Knocked away Mahar. Picked up by Dawkins. Here come the Blue Devils. 8 turnovers for Carolina. Dawkins driving lane. Bounce pass away to Henderson. Jump shot. No good. Recovered by Peterson. Peterson coming quickly front court. Lead pass to Hunter coming down against Dawkins. Will not go through. Gives it to Peterson. Peterson drives in the lane. Running one-handers off the glass. No good. Tapped up. No good. Tap back up. Peterson's follow is good, and it's 26-23. Buzz Peterson follows up on his second attempt, and Carolina back in front by three with 4:20 to play. Vic Bubas, Sun Belt Commissioner, former Duke coach, but chairman of the prestigious NCAA Division I Men's Basketball Committee, talks with Jim Hebner at halftime, and what a job he and his 9 committee members have got next week. The seed, 64 teams. Dawkins out of the corner, missed it. Hunter boxing Mahar out. Left Henderson alone to claim it. He misses the shot, and it's run down in the right corner by Peterson. Dean Smith says, get it quickly front court. Hale across the timeline on the left side, working down the sideline. Breaks his dribble, drops it to Brad Daugherty. Nice catch of the ball, knocked away Henderson. Out to Amaker, lead pass to Mahar. Mahar missed the dunk. Recovered Dawkins, saved it to Amaker. Oh. Duke still with possession.
What do you think? Dawkins stepped on the line, but Hank Nichols couldn't get there quickly enough to see it.
Amaker's missed the layup. Mahar has now missed a dunk. 26-they're changing the board now. 26-23. 3.5 minutes to play in the half. Amaker in the midcourt area wants to play a three. Henry, it looks like the Falls Church, Virginia sophomore is a bit winded. Ball lost. Hale goes to the floor, and it belongs to Duke. Hale falling to the floor, scrapping Dawkins with it. It'll still be the Blue Devils' ball, and with that, Billy King, Kevin Strickland, and Mark Allery return for Duke. But before anybody can get into the lineup, there's an official timeout taken in Durham. So
So a timeout on the floor. 3:24 left to play in the first half. The score, Carolina 20.
And in the ball game so far, Mark Allery has not scored. He's averaging nearly 17 points a game, and he is desperately needed right now by the Blue Devils because they have only got three shots inside the lane other than layups where they've made. Billis has made one. Mahar has made one, and Johnny Dawkins drove in and made one. So the inside game of Duke right now almost non-existent, and they are only shooting, Woody, 33%, which is 10 of 30.
You know, Henry, Kevin Strickland had been coming off the bench and giving Duke a lot of offensive help before the Clemson game. He'd been like 17 of 21 in his last four games. He went 1 of 6 on Wednesday night against the Tigers.
They're looking for some shooters right now. By the way, Carolina's 11 of 22. That's 50% in the ballgame.
Inbound to Allery, on the left wing, back out front to Strickland. Strickland took one look at Mahar and will keep it alive on his own dribble to Dawkins, top of the circle. 26-23, Allery left of the lane, shaking off that gimpy ankle and back into play. Dawkins to Strickland, looked inside to Mahar, can't get it to him. Allery looking right, looking left, now gives it to Dawkins on the left side. He'll drive baseline. Shot clock is down to three. Allery's got to take one from 22 feet, and it hit the bottom of the rim. No good, and Daugherty's got the rebound. Allery 0 of 6 thus far this afternoon. 26-23. Smith goes inside to Martin. Martin gets free, puts up the shot, no good, and the foul is on Allery. And that's number two on the junior from Scottsdale, Arizona. You know, in the first meeting between these two teams, Henry, he got 19 points, but he went 8 of 15 from the field. And there again is that less than 50% shooting we were talking about.
Steve Hale just came to the sideline, and he had Mark Davis, the trainer, cut away that protective device that they had kind of wrapped around his thigh. Apparently it's bothered him to the point he can't. I tell you, when you got to guard a guy like Johnny Dawkins, you got to have all your facilities with you, including your legs.
Unusual substitution, Henry, by Mike Krzyzewski. He's taken out Danny Mahar, who has only one personal, and he's inserted Todd Anderson, the 6'9 senior from Golden Valley, Minnesota, who hasn't played that much. Martin misses his first free throw. He'll have another one coming. He shoots nearly 71% from the line. 26-23, make it 27-23. Martin now with 9 points in the ball game, leads the Carolina scoring. There's a question at the scorer's table now. And it's going to be Duke's ball. The official score had a question for Tom Frame. I don't know what it was, but anyway, it's Duke's ball at the baseline. Pressure in the backcourt by the Tar Heels. Dawkins, long lead to Strickland. Dunk. Caught Carolina in the transition of the zone press. Strickland gets his first field goal. Duke within two. 27-25, Carolina. Across the timeline comes Kenny Smith. Moving left, goes back to the right. Puts it to Buzz Peterson at the right wing. Looking inside for Martin, can't get him the ball. Gives it to Daugherty, comes high post now to Peterson. Peterson drops it to Martin. Martin moving baseline, shot from behind the glass, no good. Daugherty's there, follows back up, won't go, whoop, tap followed, wouldn't go. Now he's up off the glass, it's good, and he's foul. Anderson commits the personal foul, just coming into the ball game a moment ago for Mahar. It's his first. Wolf, working like a blue-collar guy on the glass, got the bucket, and he'll go to the line with a chance for a three-point play.
What was going on just a moment ago in that last dead ball? Steve Hale had come out, was trying to get back in. There was a long delay before they shot those free throws by Warren Martin, but the ball had never been live again, so Steve Hale could not come in. That was what all the complaining at the score table was about.
29-25, Carolina make it 30-25. The Heels, who have been up by as many as 7, now lead again by 5. Duke led early by 6 at 8-2. Carolina's 7-point lead was 20-13. 2:15 to play in the half. Strickland left wing. The Dawkins out front. Carolina 1-3-1 zone. Anderson left corner. Now to Strickland. Fakes the pass across the top of the zone. Brings it on the dribble left of the circle. Dawkins penetrating. Drops it back to Strickland. Strickland's long outside jumper bounds high over the top of the glass. It's out of bounds. It'll belong to Carolina.
Boy,
2 minutes left to play in the half. Henry Hinton.
Duke having real trouble with their shooting. Mahar's 2 of 4. Allery, you mentioned 0 of 6. Billis 3 of 9. David Henderson 0 of 3. I think this still holds true, Bob Witter. Check me on this. Johnny Dawkins still 4 of 6, and Amaker 1 of 2.
Amaker and Henderson have just come back into the Duke lineup now as Duke has made a couple of substitutions. Mike Krzyzewski getting Mahar ready to go back. Called him to the scorer's table off the end of the bench. Smith to Wolf as Carolina controls at the west end of Cameron Indoor Stadium. 1:45 left to play in the half. Steve Hale on the right side. Drives baseline. Jumpers up off the glass. Good with the left hand. Steve Hale banking in his 8 point of the half. 32-25. Carolina has matched its biggest lead of the ball game. 7 points. Carolina back to the 1-3-1 defensively. Duke attacks it on the left side. Anderson at the baseline. Back to Henderson.
Henderson driving baseline, and he traveled with it. Foot slipped out from under him on a wet spot, and the Drury, North Carolina sophomore just pounds the ball to the floor in disgust as he commits Duke's third turnover. Now Buzz Peterson gets into the Carolina lineup, and he'll come in replacing Kenny Smith. Now Smith's got two fouls here with 83 seconds left to play in the first half. Dean Smith does not want the chance, picking up a third on a loose ball scramble.
Bahar also back in the ballgame replacing Anderson.
So Duke now has got Tommy Amaker, Kevin Strickland, Danny Mahar, Jay Billis, and David Henderson. Carolina with Brad Daugherty, Joe Wolf, David Popson, Buzz Peterson, and Steve Hale. Hale switches to the point now as Peterson will take the big guard spot. Daugherty down the left side to Peterson with 1:10 to play in the first half. The shot clock's at 30 seconds. Inside pass to Popson, knocked away, loose in the lane, recovered Mahar. Lead pass to Henderson against Hale. Dropped it back to Strickland, and Strickland is called for the charge into Steve Hale.
Uh-oh, Mike Krzyzewski's out of the coach's box, and Henry Nichols is about to hit him with one if he doesn't get
it. He did. Stepping just over the edge of it, down in front of the Duke bench. Strickland whistled for his second personal foul. Evidently, it came while Strickland was still in control of the ball, and so it will not be a shooting foul for Steve Hale.
The toughest call in basketball, but I think Henry Nichols made the proper call. Steve Hale had his feet planted. He just barely had them planted in time to pick up that charge, but it was an excellent defensive play, and I think a good call by the officials.
1 minute left to play in the first half. Now, actually, less than that at 50 seconds. Don't forget, Vic Bubas joined Jim Hebner at halftime by phone from Hampton, Virginia, where the Sun Belt tournament's in progress. Stay tuned for that. Peterson, top of the circle, now over to Hale on the right wing. Carolina will want to use as much time off the shot clock as possible. It's down to 21 seconds now to Popson. Back it comes to Daugherty. Cross-court pass comes to Peterson. Shot clock's at 17 seconds. Game clock's at 31. Hunter coming off the baseline. Gets it to Peterson. Near the left hash mark to Hunter. Low to Brad Daugherty. Got muscled around. Ball loose, and Strickland knocks it away over the end line. It'll still be Carolina's ball, and let's see. Will the shot clock be reset? It's at 7 seconds, and I don't believe it will be. So Carolina's got to get it in, get off a shot in 7 seconds on the shot clock. 24 seconds remaining on the game clock here in the first half. Joe Wolf is in. Carolina coaching staff giving signals, and actually Dean Smith has now stepped outside the coach's box in talking to his team, and the Duke students are letting him know just where he is with relationship to that box. Steve Hale will inbound the baseline. 7 seconds are left on the shot clock. Inbounds to Buzz Peterson. Peterson inside to Popson. Popson back out to Peterson. 22-foot jump shot. Got it! 34-25 with 16 seconds left to play in the first half. Duke quickly front court. Amaker across the timeline on the left side. Clocks at 9, 8, 7. Henderson back to Amaker. 6, 5. Henderson from well out. Off the rim, no good. Billis has got the rebound. Blocked, and Popson draws the foul with 1 second left on the clock.
Well, Dave Popson originally had the position, but there was a good example of how Jay Billis, with all that hard work he did over summer in the weight room, has really come along this year. He just muscled Dave Popson right out of the way. That's his fifth rebound of the ballgame. He just kind of pushed Dave out of the way. Dave got behind him. When the rebound came down, all Dave could do was reach over the top and get the foul.
Jay Billis coming off an 18-point performance against Clemson that was just one off his season's high of 19 set in the opener against St. Louis will be at the line where he's a 69% shooter, and he will shoot two with 1 second left on the clock. Carolina with its biggest lead of the game, 34-25. Billis's free throw is good, and it's 34-26. So Billis can give the Blue Devils a little momentum here, although Carolina will try to perhaps maybe get a last shot off here with an inbounds pass, a long one. Ranzino Smith, the Chapel Hill freshman, come in the ball game for the Heels, replacing Popson, who picked up his second foul. Shot by Billis is good. Hit short and had enough to get it over the top. Brad Daugherty inbounds to Ranzino Smith, and did the clock go? Yes, I believe it did. I thought I heard a little tweet of a horn going off, and the teams head for the dressing room as Carolina has a 7-point.
What do you think they talked about in the dressing room?
Well, I think Dean Smith probably told the Tar Heels, just keep doing what you're doing. And Mike Krzyzewski said, hey, guys, just keep shooting it. It's going in.
If it ain't broke, don't fix it. Meanwhile, the Tar Heels obviously have got to protect the ball a little bit better. They did a great job defensively in keeping the Blue Devils' shooting percentage down. Woody, it might be a good opportunity. Let's review the points per possession while we have time.
Well, Duke had 42 possessions in the first half for its 27 points. That's .643. Dean Smith's terminology, that's excellent defense. Carolina, 34 points off 39 possessions at .872. He considers .850 good offense. So it's been great defense, and
average offense for Carolina.
Jim, we checked around. We can't find out whether Mark Allery indeed does have the flu. He does look awful pale, though. One other point, too, Dean Smith may not start Warren Martin in the first half, but he's sure going to start the second half.
You bet.
Duke will have possession of the ball at the midline as we begin the final 20 minutes of the regular season here on the Tar Heel Sports Network. Duke going to the west goal in the final half of play. Carolina to the east. Mark Allery, jump shot from outside. Still no good. He's 0 for 6 officially. Martin had it, lost it to Dawkins. Dawkins trying to penetrate, lost the ball, recovered baseline, got it to Mahar. Fallaway shot, no good. Brad Daugherty and Billis went right over his back for his first personal foul, and that'll be the first team foul against Duke here at the outset of the second half.
Brad Daugherty had 7 rebounds in the first half, and Billis was 6, but there was no way that Jay Billis was going to get over Brad Daugherty's big 6'11 and a half frame to get that one.
Well, the interesting thing to me about Carolina's rebounding, Henry, is that Buzz Peterson, second leading rebounder with 4. Kenny Smith, right of the circle, gives it to Joe Wolf, who works against Mahar. Duke man-to-man. Wolf comes baseline, can't get through, bounced it to Martin. Martin from underneath, reverse layup is no good. Martin controls, bounced out of bounds, and belongs to Duke, says Hank Nichols. Martin thought he might get it back for the Tar Heels by not trying to touch it as he was being forced out of bounds, but no go. It's 34-27, and the Duke fans, almost to a man, want Hank Nichols to call traveling on the play. Tommy Amaker coming to Allery, to Mahar, to Allery. Out comes to Amaker, off to Dawkins. Dawkins shuffling the pass inside Allery, turns, laid it up, no good. He's 0 for 7. Billis recovers, and it's fouled by Steve Hale. Hale gets his second personal, first team foul of the second half. 19:01 left to play at 34-27. Henry, I wonder if all of those Duke students who get on Mr. Nichols, or Dr. Nichols, I should say, so frequently, he's the chairman of the Department of Education at Villanova University, know that Hank Nichols got his doctorate at Duke.
I don't think they care as long as he got that black and white shirt on.
You're right. Billis, foul line, no good on the free throw. He'll have another one coming.
You think they care when Maryland's here that Lefty got his degree here?
No, matter of fact, they're probably embarrassed by that. 34-27. Billis missed them both. Wolf with a rebound for Carolina. Now drops it off to Daugherty. Billis, who had hit his only 2 free throws of the first half, goes 0 for 2 at the line here at the outset of the second half. Hale down to Smith on the right sideline. Bounce pass inside to Martin. Martin double team, pass deflected, intercepted Mahar, and it's off to Amaker. First turnover of the half for Carolina. The Tar Heels in the first half had 11 compared to only 4 for Duke. 3 steals by Tommy Amaker, who controls the ball right now offensively for the Blue Devils. To Johnny Dawkins, baseline, jumper, rimmed out, wouldn't go. Smith with the rebound. Here come the Heels on the run, 2-on-2 break. Steve Hale faking Amaker, forces it up. It's no good, and Amaker draws the foul. It's his third, and that brings Mike Krzyzewski off the bench, but no real temper tantrum or anything.
Well, the Duke student section again wanted traveling. Almost everybody in the stands was calling traveling. But like Steve never really picked up his pivot foot, though, until he actually went into the act of shooting, which, of course, is not a traveling.
Hale at the free throw line, the left-hander from Jinx, Oklahoma, shooting into a sea of waving arms, converts on the free throw. He's now got 17 in a row. He and Kenny Smith, Henry, are both online to break York Larice's individual season record of 86.8% set way back in 1960. That free throw is missed, and the streak stops at 17. 35-27, Carolina by 8. Amaker moving left for the Blue Devils, gets it to Mahar inside the top of the foul circle to Dawkins on the right side. Dawkins looking low for Mahar. Martin fronting him, comes back out front to Amaker. Amaker moving left to Dawkins. Dawkins penetrating, running jump shot, blocked by Hale. Dawkins recovered inside, ball loose on the floor. Dawkins recovers, scores, and is fouled. Warren Martin got it. Martin lying flat on his back, looks up with a quizzical expression on his face as if to say, how can that happen? Basket is good. Martin's got his second foul, second team foul. Dawkins has got his 12th point of the game and a chance for the three-point play.
Well, that confrontation started very unmatched in that there's no question that Warren Martin, much taller than Johnny Dawkins, had the advantage going inside. When the ball got loose on the floor, it was also equally unmatched again as Dawkins' quickness paid off, and he got the ball and put it up as Martin only could foul him. And so it looks like Dawkins is going to get an opportunity for a three-pointer here.
Johnny Dawkins is now ninth place on Duke's all-time scoring list with his 13th point of this game, giving him 1,670 points for his career, and he's got another year to go. 35-30, Carolina by 5. Smith in the midcourt area against Dawkins. Dawkins bothering him defensively, gives it up to Hale, who works against Amaker. Inside to Darty, lost it to Smith at the baseline. Smith coming back down the baseline, drives underneath, beats Joe Wolf, lost it, hooked it up, wouldn't go, tapped in Darty, and the foul's on Darty. Will the bucket count? No! Basket disallowed. And Darty charged with a foul. Well, that's a big turn of events for the Tar Heels. Darty's first, team third, second half.
Mark Allery has not scored yet. He's taken a couple of shots that have looked a little anemic, but he's been much more active, and it looks like he's trying to pressure himself to push himself to get in the flow of the ball game. He did a pretty good job on the board that time with Brad Darty.
35-30. Duke could get within three here as Dawkins comes left to the circle to Mahar down the baseline. Back out front to Dawkins. Inside to Allery. Allery off balance. Shots up. No good. Billis with the follow. No good. And Darty's got his second. Quickly, Darty, without a foul in the first half, gets two quick ones, and that's four on Carolina as a team. Here in the second half, Duke has been called for two. To the free throw line will go Jay Billis. He is 2 of 4 in the ball game. Billis averaging 9.5 points a game. He had an outstanding game in the first meeting between these two teams at Chapel Hill. That Duke won by 16, 93-77, when he got 17 points and 11 rebounds. Free throw is good. He's now got 9 points in this ball game. He'll have another shot coming. 35-32. He can draw Duke within three, and does at 35-32. Whistle, official timeout. Tom Frame needs one of the ball boys to come out of that west end zone and wipe up a wet spot just to the left of the lane at the Duke end of the floor. Amaker's going to hang back now as Carolina will inbound the ball now, and Carolina's got all of its five players in the backcourt right now, but no trouble. Amaker ready to pick up Smith. He'll get him at the timeline and come close to it. Down the sideline to Curtis Hunter, who's then replacing Martin. Here's Smith, moving down right of the circle. Jump shots up off the front of the rim, no good. Tap followed by Wolf is no good. They tap it again, and Billis is down with it. Well, Duke's doing the better job now on the glass in the second half. Good box out underneath on the offensive board, and Duke can get within one. Mark Allery controls from Dawkins. Mahar, top of the circle, over to Amaker. Amaker driving baseline against Smith. Pushes him down, chops up, no good. And Joe Wolf got the rebound for Carolina. He dropped it off to Kenny Smith. Long front court to Hale. Hale fires it over to Hunter. Good catch of the ball, and Mahar got a nice hand on it to knock it away over the end line, because Curtis Hunter was going to get an easy bucket had it not been for the quick hands of Canadian Danny Mahar.
Excellent defense by Mahar. You can hear the Duke students saying Mahar in the background. They really love him here. This is his last game in Cameron Indoor Stadium, and he's not had an outstanding game shooting the ball today, but he's played very good defense.
Well, there's some question at the scores table what it is. They're having to put the 45-second clock down to 35 seconds. Joe Forte, the referee, had gone over to talk to the 45-second shot clock operator about that. So now it's set at 35, and Carolina will inbound baseline. I believe it had been set at 45 when the ball got knocked away out of bounds. Hale drops it to Wolf. Carolina with possession on the right side. The Tar Heel lead is only three. Kenny Smith back door. Darty against Billis. Can't get him the ball. Tried to get it to Hale. Thrown away. Hale stripped to the ball by Dawkins. Reverse layup on the dunk. 35-34. Duke is within one. 15 points for Dawkins. Now the Duke crowd is really back in the game, sensing that the Blue Devils may have the momentum needed to pull this one out. Kenny Smith drops it to Curtis Hunter at the left wing. Hunter against Mahar, drives into the lane, stops, jump shot, no good. Wolf with a rebound, back out front to Hale. Hale drops it off to Hunter. Hunter will again go baseline against Mahar. Passes to Wolf, knocked away, recovered Darty. Darty will come back up top to Hale. He penetrates on the drive, loops it up good, and he's fouled. Foul is on Jay Billis, and it will be number two on the Rolling Hills, California junior. I don't know what in the world Steve Hale saw. Nothing looked like a lane to me down that lane as we look at it from, up in the battens, really, at Cameron Indoor Stadium. But somehow, Steve Hale fought his way through there for his 11th point of the game, and he'll have a chance for the three-point play on Duke's third team foul and the second on Billis, both of which have been in the second half, Henry.
Woody, I don't know how much it has to do with the fact that Curtis Hunter's playing in his hometown, but he's really struggling this afternoon, and he's trying to force things that aren't there.
Rebounded by Billis. Darty from behind, almost drawing his third. Hale's missed two in a row now after 17 straight. 37-34, Carolina. Duke with the ball.
And quickly, Warren Martin back in the game replacing Curtis Hunter.
Amaker moving right of the circle, gives it to Dawkins. Jump shot, 20 feet. Wouldn't go. Up against the glass, knocked out of bounds by Duke. Billis and Mahar were fighting each other for it, and it went out of bounds. And right now, an official timeout being taken at Cameron Indoor Stadium. And I'll tell you one thing, these teams need a break.
Like your mom.
A whole lot of activity underneath, Woody. Billis's high game rebounding this year. Henry was 11 in the opener against St. Louis when he also got 19 points. 37-34. Kenny Smith across the timeline. Carolina with a three-point lead and the basketball. Smith driving into the lane. Takes it in. Dropped it to Darty. Couldn't control it. And Dawkins comes away with it. Second turnover of this half. 13 for the game for Carolina. Dawkins going baseline. Dropped it back to Allery. Shots up. Blocked out of bounds by Martin. And for Warren Martin, his 63rd block shot of the season. Duke will have it at the baseline. 15-14 to play. 37-34 Carolina.
Carolina just not taking very good care of the basketball right now.
The shot clock again is at 44 seconds, and Hank Nichols has pointed to it, and they're having trouble with the shot clock operator. Well, the shot clock operator is having trouble operating the shot clock.
Well, the minute he pointed to it, Henry Nichols pointed to it, they started counting it down, but now they've reset it at 45.
Guy must be hitting the wrong button. 37-34. Dawkins off the left sideline. Duke with a chance to get back within one. Carolina's led by as many as eight here in this half. Dropped inside Allery. Blocked Martin. Recovered Hale. Allery having his shot attempt blocked. Hale away to Smith now. Coming front court down the left to Martin at the baseline. Backing in the lane. Hook. Good. 39-34. Mike Krzyzewski is livid. He says there's no way he can make that move without walking. And Hank Nichols runs by the bench and comes to Mike Krzyzewski saying, sit down. 39-34. Allery, top of the circle to Amaker. Over to Dawkins. Long outside shot. No good. Darty's got it. And the whistle and the foul is called on Danny Mahar.
Oh, boy.
For pulling Joe Wolf down. Dan Mahar whistle for his second personal foul. And Dan says, you mean it's my last game in Cameron Indoor Stadium and I can't get away with one?
Well, he's... Got to be careful what you say in a case like this. But Mahar has been known to do that on some rebound situations. And matter of fact, he and Lenny Bias in the Maryland game here a couple of weeks ago got into a real scrap over it. Bias was the guy who got the tech. But Mahar has, at times, what he calls some ruckus on situations like that.
39-34. Carolina by five, and with the basketball, that was the fourth team foul against Duke. Second on Mahar, Joe Wolf to Steve Hale, penetrating, dumps it to Darty, up for the shot, no good, and the foul is on Danny Mahar, and it's his third. Mahar picked up two quick ones, fifth team foul against the Blue Devils, with 14:20 left to play in the contest. Mike Krzyzewski looking down the bench, talking to assistant Pete Godette, has not yet called anybody to him as Brad Darty, with 6 points in the first half, goes to the line. 12 double-figure scoring and rebounding games on the year for this young man. Free throw is good. It's 40-34. And so many people forget he's only 19 years old.
Is he still 19? He's been 19
well,
a long time.
He came to Carolina 17. He just became 19 the 19th of October, 1984. 40-34. Next free throw is good. It's 41-34. Carolina up by seven. Dawkins across the timeline on the high dribble as Duke moves to the west goal. To David Henderson, the Drury North Carolina product who's in the game. Henderson penetrating, can't get the shot away to Dawkins. Over to Amaker on the right side. Whips it to Mahar at the right baseline. He throws it across the top of the zone to Henderson. Drives baseline, bumps Martin, can't get through. Back out front it comes to Amaker. Amaker looking to Dawkins, gives it to him top of the circle. Carolina 1-3-1 zone. Henderson to Dawkins. Dawkins penetrates, jump shot, 13 feet good. 41-36, Johnny Dawkins now with 17. He had a career high of 34 in the first meeting between these two teams. 41-36. Wolf to Smith at the right wing. Smith puts it to the floor against Tommy Amaker. Moving back now, gives it to Wolf. Drops it off to Hale on the left. Goes inside to Martin. Knocked out of his hands by Henderson. It'll still be Carolina's ball out of bounds at the baseline.
Warren Martin has had the same kind of effect on the ballgame he had in the first half. When he came in just a moment ago, Carolina was at 37-34. Now they've picked up a little more steam. They can go ahead by seven.
Smith inbound play. He tried to get it to Martin. Martin breaking around the top of the circle, moving from left to right, was out of position. Smith throws it out of bounds, but it was deflected, going out by Duke. And it will still be Carolina's, no. Yes, it's going to be Carolina's ball.
The Duke students are saying, watch Warren walk.
Hale drops it inbounds to Joe Wolf. Drops it right back to Hale, and he's across the timeline. Moves hash mark right side in front of the Tar Heel bench.
Here goes Hale to the baseline, drives all the way through, laid it up left-handed, and it was blocked partially by Billis, saved by Mahar off to Dawkins. Duke with a chance to get within three again. Dawkins pulls up, we got a whistle, and the foul is on Warren Martin, and Forte scrapping in to make the call as his feet slide out from under him. Mike Krzyzewski wants two shots. He wants an intentional foul call. And the ball boys, meanwhile, will come out to wipe up that wet spot. Joe Forte ran right into the top of the circle where those wet bodies had gone to the floor, and his feet just slid right out from under him, and he did a nice sit-down right on his rump.
Well, you know, Dean Smith and Bill Guthridge are very mad because they're saying, hey, Joe, what you did, that's exactly what happened to Warren. When he came through, he just slipped down and knocked down somebody else, and they called a foul. What do you think? That one might make Johnny Carson's funny sports play in a couple of weeks.
Third foul for Warren Martin, and that's the fifth team foul against Carolina here in the second half. And a lot of fouling is being done by the ball boys in that west free throw lane. Martin is out now as Dave Popson has come in. And it's going to be Duke's ball out of bounds. Krzyzewski wanted two shots for an intentional foul. He'll not get it. The Duke students are really working on Martin, who's gone to the Carolina bench. Henderson will inbound baseline, gets it to Amaker at the right wing. 41-36, Carolina by five. Henderson, right corner, flat jump shot, no good. Mahar taps it, but it was picked up by Hale. Off to Smith. Smith coming down, bounced it to Popson, knocked away Amaker. Amaker with three first-half steals, going quickly the other way. He looked like he carried it, knocked away, picked up by Hale. Here's Hale coming front court. Hale, reverse dribble, takes him into the lane, drops it to Popson, laid it up, no good. And let's see, I believe the foul may be on who? Steve Hale for the charge, unbelievable. Steve Hale called for the charge. It's his third, 16 foul against Carolina.
Dean Smith just turned his head and said, I don't believe it.
I thought the foul had been called when Popson had his shot blocked by David Henderson. But stepping inside to take it, I believe, was Johnny Dawkins. And it's Dawkins who gets it across the timeline with 12:50 to play, and Duke with another chance to get within three. Blue Devils down by five, led early by six. Carolina's been up by as many as eight here in the second half. Allery, left corner, first field goal of the ballgame. Coming with 12:35 to play. He had gone 0-10 before he made that shot. 41-38, Carolina by three. Tar Heels find themselves in a position now where a basket is needed. Popson foul line off to Joe Wolf, pushes it away to Kenny Smith. Inside Daugherty turns in the lane and scores. Right over the top of Mahar. Brad Daugherty now with 10 points. And it's 43-38, Carolina by five. Amaker through the center jump circle, gets it away to Henderson, right left corner to Allery. Popson tightening up on him to Henderson. Look away to Dawkins, jump shot, deep right corner, no good. Daugherty with a rebound. Henderson all over him, bounce pass away to Smith. Smith across the timeline quickly to the right side. Drops it to Joe Wolf. Wolf gets a nice screen from Popson and buries the jump shot. 45-38. Joe Wolf with seven. Mike Krzyzewski calling Danny Mahar off the Duke bench with 11:45 to play. Dawkins right through the center jump circle, gets it over to Amaker on the right side. Comes now back to Dawkins, drops it to Henderson on the left. High lob inside, Billis, back up, shot good, 45-40. Jay Billis is carrying the offensive load for the Blue Devils right now. He and Dawkins with 17, Billis with 12. 45-40, Carolina by five, Wolf in the midcourt area against Allery. Got it to Daugherty, made a good catch of the ball in the lane, laid it up, too strong, tapped by Popson, controlled Allery off to Dawkins. He'll try to go quickly front court, can't get through, waits on his white-shirted teammates to get there now with just over 11 minutes to play. Pushes to Allery, shot in lane, good. Well, Allery's made two in a row. He was quiet for a long time, but he's warming up. 45-42, Duke back within three. Kenny Smith through the center jump circle. Gets it away to Wolf at the left wing. Allery all over him. Wolf a bounce into Daugherty. Daugherty up off the glass, and it's good. Henderson overplaying Daugherty. Daugherty made a nice catch, turned, and puts in his 12th point. 47-42, Carolina. Through the center jump circle comes Amaker. The Blue Devils are back to the attack. Dawkins, Allery, left corner, back to Dawkins. Henderson moving through the lane. Goes to Amaker, back to Dawkins on the left side. 10.5 minutes to go. Look away to Henderson, baseline. Jumpers up, no good. Whistle and the foul is on Steve Hale, and it's his fourth. Steve Hale has just picked up his fourth personal foul. I believe that is correct. It's going up on the scoreboard right now.
It is, with 10:25 to play, and that's the seventh team foul, but Henderson's going to shoot a pair anyway. And right now, an official timeout being taken at Cameron Indoor Stadium in Durham, I think. Well, we thought for a moment they were going to go, but they got to shoot the one and one before the timeout can be taken. Actually, two shots coming for David Henderson.
Warren Martin back in the game again, and immediately the entire Duke student section standing up doing the official's call for traveling.
David Henderson, who so far from the field is 1-for-5. He went only 1-of-10 in the first meeting between these two teams. He's now 0-for-1 at the foul line. Too strong, coming off the back of the iron. He's had 58 points in his last four games for a 14.5 average. 47-42. Next one is no good. Rebounded by Martin. He steps inside Allery to come away with it. And so it remains 47-42. Henderson making 1-of-2 free throws inside to Daugherty. Layup is good. Brad Daugherty for Carolina at the other end with 14. 49-42. Carolina by 7.
Big free throw misses by David Henderson, missing two of those there.
Strickland gives it to Dawkins at the top of the circle. Carolina in the zone, pushes it back to Strickland. The freshman gives it right back to the veteran Dawkins. Back to come at Strickland, drives baseline, bounce pass away to Mahar. Mahar driving inside, lays it up off the glass. No good, tapped in Allery. Allery with 6, and it's 49-44 with 9:45 to play in the ball game. Smith through the center jump circle. Hesitates a moment in the midcourt area, but kept his dribble alive. Now pushes it to Hunter on the right side. Back it comes to Smith. He works on Dawkins. Over to Peterson. Peterson looking for Daugherty. Allery trying to front him. Nice pass inside. Daugherty off the baseline. About 5 feet is good. And that's 16 now for Brad Daugherty. He had 18 points, 11 rebounds in the first meeting between these two teams. 51-44. Carolina by 7. Duke changing up its offense now. Mahar in the lane as Henderson gives it to Dawkins. Long outside shot is no good. Martin with a rebound. Had Mahar boxed out below left. Lead pass to Hunter. Hunter coming down against Henderson. Feeds it to Peterson. He saved it at the right baseline. Goes into the corner. Needs to come back out for help and gets it to Kenny Smith on the right side. 8:55 to play. Down to Buzz Peterson. Fake Strickland. One dribble. Jump shot. Good. 53-44. The Carolina lead is 9, and Mike Krzyzewski will use a timeout. He can't wait on the official timeout. So with 8:45 to play, timeout on the floor, called by Duke. It's first, the score, Carolina 53, Duke.
Georgia Tech, and he's doing that. Carolina had gone 0-of-5 to start the second half, and then they've hit their last 8, or rather 10, 8 of their last 10, Woody. 53% shooting in the second half, 8 of 15. Duke is 33% in the second half, 7 of 22. But again, 5 turnovers for Carolina in the second half. They really aren't protecting it very well, especially in the transition game.
Dawkins across the timeline, moving right wing, comes to Billy King, top of the circle. One dribble, the freshman gives it up to Henderson. Inside he goes to Mahar, back to Henderson. Jump shot, 15 feet, right on the foul line is good. 53-46, David Henderson's got his first field goal of the game. 8:25 remaining to be played. Carolina by 7 as Smith is across the timeline left side. Spinning away from Dawkins, he comes right. Now will drive into the lane. Tried to get a bounce pass away to Buzz Peterson. Kicked by Billy King. The shot clock will be reset, and Carolina will have it out of bounds right in front of the student body along Press Road. Peterson will play it in from the wing. Got to get rid of it. Gets it in to Smith. Smith against Johnny Dawkins. 53-46. Smith now coming right side. Picks up his dribble now. Bounce pass away to Peterson, who works against Billy King. Now he'll come back to the baseline. Lost off Buzz Peterson. Went out of bounds. That'll give the ball over to Duke. Carolina's 6 turnover of the half. 17 for the game. 53-46. King gives the ball inbounds on the bounce pass to Johnny Dawkins. Both coaches who had birthdays this month. Mike Krzyzewski at midweek. Dean Smith earlier this, or at mid-month, Dean Smith earlier this week are both up off the benches talking to their respective players. 17-5, the disparity in turnovers. Here's Henderson in the lane. Drops it away to King. King moving in from the right to Mahar. Jump shot, 15 feet. Went in, popped out. Peterson had it, lost it. King recovers. Won't go. Allery was there. Back up. Scores and is fouled. It's on Brad Daugherty or Warren Martin. We'll wait on Hank Nichols' call. It's on Brad Daugherty, his third, all of which have come here in the second half. This one with 7:38 to play. It's 53-48. And Mark Allery, who was quiet, now has 8 and has got a chance to get 9.
He's gotten all 8 of those points, Woody. in the last about 5 minutes of the ball game. He hadn't scored before that.
Free throw by Allery is good. It is 53-49, and a timeout has been taken. 7:38 to play with an official timeout called in Durham. The score, Carolina 53, Duke 49.
Stadium, Carolina's lead has been cut to four at 53-49. Woody, the timeout that Mike Krzyzewski took a moment ago at 8:45 turned out to be a good one. Since that time, Duke has scored five unanswered points. Carolina now turnovers 17-5. Duke's only had one turnover in the second half. They don't make very many. You mentioned earlier about what a great job that the guards do, especially Tommy Amaker, of not turning it over, and they've done that again today. That's been one of the keys for Duke. While Carolina's continue to hammer at them, they've gotten pretty good shots and played with the ball pretty well, keeping good control of it.
Duke's going to put on pressure in the backcourt, but Daugherty gets the inbound pass to Smith. 53-49. Carolina's lead is only four. Smith angling left side, turning, coming back to the right. Kenny Smith against Johnny Dawkins. Picks up his dribble now, needs some help. Got to get rid of it. Finally pushes it away to Brad Daugherty at the left baseline. Brad holds it high, gives it right back to Steve Hale. Hale at the foul line. Off to Joe Wolf. Jumper 13 feet by Wolf is good. 55-49. Wolf with 9 points for Carolina. He didn't play with Curtis Hunter in the first game. Both were injured at that time when they met in mid-January at Chapel Hill. 7:05 left to play. King to Allery, left corner, back to King. King against Kenny Smith. Can't get through. David Henderson, jump shot, 18 feet, no good. Bounds long. Kenny Smith tapping it, trying to keep it alive, knocked it out of bounds. It'll be Duke's ball in a new 45-second clock. Count is on the shot clock. 55-49. Of course, Duke now not trying to conserve time. The Blue Devils are trying to make up points. Allery drops it into Henderson, comes to King, pushes it inside Allery, turnaround from 12 feet, wouldn't go down. Joe Wolf got the rebound, knocked away, and the foul is called on Duke. It's on David Henderson of the Blue Devils, and it will be his second. That also is the 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 team foul against Duke. So Carolina gets the ball out of bounds. Tar Heels not yet in the bonus with 6:48 to go.
Good rebound by Joe Wolf. He's got 8 in the ballgame. He's been a big factor, Woody. Maybe the big factor over how this game was played back in Chapel Hill.
His tie game this season, Henry, 9 against Oral Roberts in December. Lob pass to Martin. Tried to pass it. It hit the rim. Recovered by Wolf. Wolf in one dribble. Dropped it to Martin. Knocked away. Picked up by Amaker. Here come the Blue Devils. Lead to Johnny Dawkins. Pulls up. 13 feet. Got it. 55-51. Dawkins now with 19. Carolina lead is only four again with 6:20 to play. Smith across the timeline against Tommy Amaker. They've made a defensive switch now and put Amaker on Smith, and Dawkins has taken Hale. I think maybe Kenny Smith might have been wearing Dawkins out a little bit. Joe Wolf baseline, drive, laid it up left-handed. Right-handed, it wouldn't go. Rebounded Duke. Blue Devils with a chance to get within two. Dawkins, no good. Rebounded Brad Daugherty. Look for the outlet, couldn't make it. Now gives it to Smith. Amaker dropped back, didn't try for the steal. Whistle, and Tom Frame is asked for timeout. There's a wet spot in the middle of the lane at the Carolina offensive end of the floor, and the ball boys quickly tend to it.
On the last rebound by Carolina, Mark Allery got knocked to the floor, and the sweat apparently made a very slippery spot. Tom Frame very quickly had to call that timeout, but I don't think Dean Smith especially appreciated the timing of it when Carolina was getting the transition going.
55-51, Carolina by four. 5:45 to play as Kenny Smith crosses the timeline on the right side against Amaker. He works top of the circle. Now comes back to the right. Here comes King behind. Got it away to Wolf. Inside to Martin. Lobbed it to Daugherty. Laid it up. It's good, and he's fouled. And the foul is on Danny Mahar. It's his fourth. Mahar, the Canadian, picked up 3 personal fouls here in the second half. Has got 4 for the game, 7th team foul. And for Brad Daugherty, it's his 18th point of the contest. He'll have a chance for the 3-point play.
What a nice, nice pass by Warren Martin, and he really liked it when the ball went through the hole. Tom Frame has taken a minute to talk to the Duke guys. I'm not sure they really thought the foul was on Mahar. Mahar was a little bit out of the play there, but there was certainly enough guys around Brad Daugherty. He was hacked on the arm as he made the basket. Good power move by Brad.
Mahar has had to sit down now as Phyllis has come back into the Duke lineup. Free throw by Daugherty. Good. And it's 58-51. The Carolina lead now at 7 on Daugherty's 19th point of the game. That matches, well, it betters what he had in the first meeting with 18 points and 11 rebounds.
Dawkins to Amaker, left side to Allery, long outside shot, no good. Martin with a rebound, look for the outlet, knocked away, and King draws the foul. Billy King picks up his first, and with 5:22 left to play, we'll move down to the east end of Cameron Indoor Stadium, where Warren Martin, the junior from Axton, Virginia, will be at the line. We talked about the fact that Warren was really just not even a factor. He was had a very indifferent performance on Wednesday night against Georgia Tech with only 2 points, three rebounds, went 1-4 from the field. But, Henry, he's come off the bench today to provide a spark both first and second half.
Woody, Tim Cafferty's keeping a shot chart for us today as Warren Martin makes his first free throw.
59-51.
The left side of the court has not been very good to Duke today. Only one shot over there. That was the first shot that Mark Allery made at about the 12-minute mark. Carolina's played good defense, apparently, on the strong side.
Martin made them both. He's got 13 in this game, and it's 60-51. It's a 9-point Carolina lead with 5:20 to play. Amaker looking inside the Carolina 1-3-1 zone to Henderson on the left. Back to Amaker, now to Dawkins. Dawkins pushes away to Allery. He comes baseline, laid it up right over the top of the glass, or right over the top of the rim. He didn't use the glass, and it went right over the top of the basket where it was rebounded by Joe Wolf. Off to Kenny Smith. Tar Heels, of course, want to use as much of the 45-second shot clock as possible.
Mark Allery's 4 of 17 on the afternoon, less than 25%.
Smith working against Amaker. Krzyzewski's made a defensive change here in the second half. Inside to Daugherty, turns off the baseline and scores. 62-51, and it's an 11-point Carolina lead. 21 points for Brad Daugherty. He has been sensational. I've got him on my first team. I've already voted.
I think if he wasn't there, he may be after today.
62-51, Amaker off balance, jump shot, good. 62-53, great play by Johnny Dawkins of Duke, and he's got 21 also. Here's Kenny Smith, front court, pulls up at the hash mark on the right side, bounce pass to Wolf. West come well out to help, brings Henderson with him, and Henderson takes the foul. Foul on David Henderson is his third, and Wolf will go to the free throw line. And Henry, as the clock continues to run down, we're starting to get into the area, and I don't think we'll be there until we're inside 3 minutes, where if Carolina maintains the lead, as Popson now has replaced Martin, that Duke will have to start fouling to try to get the ball back and hope Carolina misses.
Got to hand it to Carolina in this very tight arena, very warm day, very vocal crowd, and they have fought back. Every time Duke's gotten in the ballgame, somehow they've been able to pull away again, and they're about to enjoy their biggest lead of the day, and they do.
63-53. Joe Wolf now with 10 points to his credit. He's 4 of 4 at the free throw line. He'll have another one coming. 4:15 remaining to be played. Carolina could match its biggest lead right here and does.
That's
64-53.
Sorry, I missed that a minute ago. Of course, they were leading by 11 a minute ago at 62-51, too, Woody.
Well, you said it was warm. I know that accounts for the beads of perspiration on your forehead. Amaker, baseline to Henderson. Can't get through. Amaker, back to Henderson, drives baseline, laid it up, wouldn't go. Whistle fouls on Daugherty, and it's his fourth. Now, it would appear to me that with Daugherty picking up his fourth personal foul and still 4-0, two, I believe, left on the clock. That two, I can't tell where it's a two or a six. But anyway, Duke will put David Henderson at the foul line on the eighth turnover by Carolina, or rather, it's an eight. Bob Woodruff, our statistician, says he thinks it's an eight. Anyway, Carolina's going to have to think about putting that ball away in the four corners for as much as it can off the 45-second clock with the foul problem. And remember, Dean Smith, he's done it this year. The 45-second clock still allows you to use that four corners some.
Boy, David Henderson's missed some big free throws here. He's missed three in a row now, finally cans one.
Well, Henderson, for the ball game, is 2 of 4. He's got 4 points in the contest, 64-54. Popson's in. He's got the pass now in the backcourt against the Blue Devil pressure. Kenny Smith gives it up to Popson. Popson's got to do something with it in a hurry to get it across the timeline. Got it to Wolf. Wolf in the midcourt area. Away now to Daugherty. Daugherty gives it to Popson. Driving layup is good. I think for a moment he wanted to dunk it, and then he changed his mind, and the darn thing just barely got off the top and in. 66-54 with 3:40 to play. David Henderson deep in the left corner from Dawkins. Back to Amaker. Amaker pulls up, shoots the 15-footer. No good. Rebounded Mahar, who's back in. He misses it. Daugherty fighting to keep it alive. Henderson's got it. Knocked outside. Picked up by Smith. Three-on-one break. Smith away to Popson. Almost knocked away. Now is taken away by Dawkins. Oh. 3:20 to play. Here's Dawkins, front court against Daugherty. Drives in. Lays it up. No good. Blew the layup and the whistle, and the foul is called on Duke.
Woody, I thought Johnny Dawkins double dribble way up court. Looked like when he was trying to change hands, he kind of hit it with both hands and then changed hands, but it was no call.
Doesn't make any difference. He missed a free throw. Now Carolina missed a layup, and now Carolina's going to shoot. Brad Daugherty with another opportunity to add on to his very impressive totals today.
Henry, I'm not sure we gave the foul. It was on Billis. It's his third as Daugherty goes to the line now. He's 3 of 3 all here in the second half. 21 points for the game. Brad taking his time, looking into a sea of waving arms in that east end zone. Free throw is no good. Popson tapping it outside, but it's controlled by Dawkins. Here come the Blue Devils, quickly front court with 3:15 to play. Amaker driving, passes to Dawkins, 20-footer, no good. Daugherty with a rebound, pulls it down, protects it in the lane. Amaker trying to knock it out of his hands, but can't do it. Smith with the rebound. Big rebound for Daugherty going up in that traffic with 4 personal fouls. Way now to Popson on the right side against Mahar. Drops it back to Smith. We're under 3 minutes to play, and Amaker reaches around Kenny Smith for his 4th personal foul.
Woody, Carolina's done what I didn't think was possible. They've kind of taken the crowd out of the game now. They've run up their biggest lead late in the ballgame. I really didn't expect that to happen. Daugherty was 3 of 4 in the first half field goal wise. He's 6 of 7, says Bob Woodard, for the second half. 3 of 4 from the line.
Kenny Smith will go to the free throw line, and Kenny Smith is without a point in the ballgame. He has taken only 3 shots. Kenny, 2 in the first half, 1 in the second. He's missed all of them, but Kenny's been content really to run the offense and give up the ball. Smith ready on the free throw, and it's good, 67-54. And it's going to be interesting to find out after the game about the defensive switch that Mike Krzyzewski made midway the second half when he took Dawkins off of Smith, who I think might have been wearing Dawkins out a little bit with a lot of his movement, put Amaker on him and made the switch over to Steve Hale with Johnny Dawkins. Anyway, as Smith cans his second one, a second timeout is called, an official timeout. 2:52 to play. The score, Carolina 68, Duke.
Duke shooting stats, Woody, they've taken 71 shots, hit 22 of them. That's 31% shooting. That's about where they are for the second half, too, at 31%.
Dawkins penetrating, dumps it to Henderson. Short baseline jumper is no good. Rimmed out. Mahar had the rebound, lost it, and the foul has been called on Warren Martin. Martin has his, he's coming to the bench like it may be his 5th. I think it's only his 4th. Warren Martin, that's his 4th foul. I think he thought it might have been his 5th. He headed toward the bench like that was all she wrote, Dear John. 2:44, Buzz Peterson is going to replace him in the lineup as Mahar will go to the free throw line. Danny shoots 69% at the line. Today, Henry, is the 114th game Mahar has played in during his career at Duke. He made only 2 visits before he came to Duke, one of them to a Big Ten school and the other one to Duke University here in Durham. Free throw is up and it's good. 68-55 with 2:44 to play. The Carolina lead is 13. That's Mahar's 5th point of the game, first of the second half.
He's 2 of 6 from the floor, Woody.
He'll have another shot coming. A member of the Canadian Olympic team and the 83 World University gold medal team knocks in his second one. He will now come out with a 68-56 score, and Billy King will replace him. Duke's going to put on full court pressure now. Brad Daugherty will inbound the ball, does to Steve Hale. Hale caught up in the double team, got it to Joe Wolf. Joe Wolf free to the open, Buzz Peterson, he'll get the dunk. Well, I exaggerate a little bit because Buzz just did get it over the top of the rim, but as it closes, probably he'll come to a dunk. We get a whistle and a foul on Joe Wolf for the block as Henderson drove the baseline. 70-56 the score, and there's an exchange of words in the lane between Billy King and Brad Daugherty, and Dave Henderson, who's one of the great young men you'll ever run across, steps in to be the intermediary and gets things cool down rather quickly. Henderson will go to the line.
Boy, David Henderson's had his problems. He is really kind of a either all-on or all-off type player. He was all-on against Georgia Tech last weekend, but today he's only been 1 of 9 from the floor. He's had his problems.
Free throw is up, and it's no good. It rolled off the top of the rim. Dawkins slapped away by Daugherty. Controlled by Smith, and he's fouled by David Henderson, and Henderson has his 4th. Brad Daugherty with a block, and to say that Brad Daugherty, the junior from Black Mountain, North Carolina, has done everything today, Henry, would be an understatement.
Boy, he really has. This has got to be one of Brad's better games.
Brad Daugherty with 12 rebounds, 1 assist. That was his first block shot, only 3 turnovers. And in between, he's found time to score 21 points.
Not a bad afternoon.
Kenny Smith at the line with 2:27 to play. 70-56, Carolina by 14. We'll spend a long time playing the last 2.5 minutes of this one. Kenny Smith's free throw is good. 71-56. Smith with 3 points in the ball game, and they've all come at the foul line. Again, there is some words between Mahar and Brad Daugherty, and Hank Nichols went right down to say something to Mahar about it.
Well, Brad Daugherty's not backing off either. Brad came back and had to say, Brad kind of got the last word in on that one, I think. For now, anyway, of course, there's 2:27 remaining in the game.
71-56, make it 72-56. Kenny Smith with four. 2.5 minutes left to play in the ballgame. 2:25, actually. Dawkins away on the bounce. Sammaker gets it right back from 20 feet. Good. 72-58, and Duke will use its second timeout. There's timeout on the floor. 2:19 remaining to be played with the score. Carolina 72, Duke 58.
Stutz Ford only deals in good used cars, and they back them up. Buy a used car from Stutz Ford, 1980 model or younger, and get a 20...
.219 remaining in the game. 72-58, Carolina with a 14-point lead now. And Johnny Dawkins just hit that last shot. He is 10 of 21 for the day. He also now has 23 points for the game. That'll move him into eighth place in the all-time scoring list at Duke. He'll pass Ronnie Mayer of the 53-56 era and Randy Denton, who you might remember played here from 69-71. So,
Henry, it dates me. I remember Ronnie Mayer, for goodness sake.
Well, probably a lot of people do, too, Woody.
Duke will put on pressure in the backcourt now against the Tar Heels. Joe Wolf runs the baseline, gets it into Brad Daugherty. And Allery reaches right around and fouls him very quickly for his third foul. 2 seconds elapsed off the clock. We're down to 2:17. Off the bench today is another interesting stat. Carolina has gotten 23 points off its bench today, while Duke has gotten 5. And 13 of those points, of those 23, have come from Warren Martin. 8 by Buzz Peterson. 4 by Dave Popson. I think that's it. Brad Daugherty at the free throw line to shoot 1-1, Henry.
Carolina's front line took a little heat in the press on Thursday morning after the loss to Georgia Tech, but today they've been pretty good. Joe Wolf is 3 of 7, Popson 2 of 3, Brad Daugherty 9 of 11. Warren Martin has been 5 of 7 as Brad Daugherty makes the free throw. Total 19 of 28 for the front line of Carolina. That's 68%, and that, of course, does not include Buzz Peterson and Curtis Hunter.
For the last 6 ball games, Brad Daugherty is averaging 20.5 points a game and shooting 69%. And he just got that free throw for his 23rd point of the game, 74-58. Allery on the drive, dunks it. Duke will choose its third timeout. The Blue Devils have only one more remaining. Allery getting his 10th point of the game, and we're going to be gone now for 70 seconds because we're going to pause for some messages from the sponsors who make this broadcast possible, as well as station identification.
2 of 6, Mark Allery, 4 of 17. David Henderson, 1 of 9. And Jay Billis, 4 of 12 for a total of 11 of 44. That's 25% shooting on the front
Wolf
line.
Wolf inbounds the ball to Smith against Duke's pressure. Fox at 2:05. Kenny Smith leads to Steve Hale coming down the left sideline. Can't get through. He'll come now to the middle. He's going to be triple team. Got it away to Brad Daugherty. Daugherty well out to Buzz Peterson, and the Tar Heels are spreading out the offense now to Steve Hale at the baseline. He's in trouble. Back out front it comes to Peterson. Tap pass over to Kenny Smith. Alert play by the Asheville senior. Smith away to Hale. 1:45 left. The shot clock's got 18 seconds left on it. Daugherty tried to pass it away to Kenny Smith, and it got knocked out of bounds by Johnny Dawkins, and that will be a new 40... No, they haven't reset it. I beg your pardon. Tough to tell sometimes. That ball's got to be kicked out or actually really dislodged before that shot clock resets. So 15 seconds are still on the shot clock. Inbounds to Daugherty from Smith along the baseline. He's in trouble. Moving up the sideline. Mahar knocks it away, and Brad lobs it back out front to Kenny Smith. Deflected by Dawkins. Now Kenny Smith, shot clock's at 2:01. Buzz Peterson, right wing, went in, popped out. Mahar's got the rebound with 1:25 to play. 74-60, but I think Carolina accomplished its mission. Henderson drives, lays it up. Duke will not use its last timeout. Not yet. 74-62. Henderson on only his second field goal of the game. Carolina trying to get the ball front court. Intercepted. Dawkins with 1:09 to play. Here's Dawkins. Alley-oop to Henderson, and he tapped it right in. Henderson's got 2 quick field goals. 74-64 with 1 minute to go. Kenny Smith threw the Duke defense, took it all the way, laid it up, and it's good. Kenny Smith makes it 76-64. Quickly, Amaker with a jump shot, no good. Rebounded Allery. He fell over Hale. No foul called. Allery shot's no good. Ball loose, recovered Amaker. He lobs it up. It goes, and Duke will use its last timeout.
21 seconds are all that remain in this ball game. Duke is out of timeout, using its fourth and last timeout on the floor to score. Carolina 76, Duke 66.
8.8% financing continues at Hunter Chevrolet Volvo Subaru 2 on a select number of 1985 Chevrolet trucks. 8.8% APR, 60-month payments, $800 cash or trade, plus North Carolina sales tax, buys you an S10 extended cab truck, an S10 truck, or an S10 4x4. 8.8.
Georgia Tech 74, St. Louis 64. 10 points left, in the 10 points difference in this ballgame, Woody. 41 seconds. But I tell you, Duke has fought back here in the last couple of minutes and outscored Carolina 8-2. Strategy now by Mike Krzyzewski is to put players in the game to draw fouls. Jay Bryan, the senior from Lakewood, Colorado, is in. Todd Anderson is replacing Danny Mahar. Well, has Mike Krzyzewski taking out Danny Mahar? Is he running up the flag of surrender with 41 seconds left and out of timeout? 76-66. Wolf inbounds the ball to Steve Hale. Hale across the timeline against Henderson. Amaker coming up from behind him. Hale leaning in and a whistle, and the foul has been called on Tommy Amaker, and he's through for the day.
Mike Krzyzewski wants charge on that play.
Well, he might have a good argument. Steve really leaned in trying to draw that foul, and Amaker, fouling out for only the third time this season, is leaving the ball game. And Henry Healy is with 5 points, but much like Kenny Smith, he took it on himself to run the show offensively today for the Blue Devils.
Darn good defense, too, Woody, by Amaker.
2 of 6 from the field, 1 of 2 at the line for his 6. He becomes the first player to foul out. We may see more before the final 36 seconds are played. To the line will go Steve Hale. He had a streak of 17 in a row broken today. As a matter of fact, he's missed his last 2. Kenny Smith has run his streak to 20 in a row today, but Hale buries this one. Steve Hale now with 12 points in the ballgame, came in averaging 11-3, scored 12 points, had 6 assists in the first meeting between these two teams. 77-66, make it 78-66. Steve Hale now with 13 points. Don't forget, we'll go to the media room, hear from both coaches, and into the dressing room as well. Dawkins stripped to the ball by Steve Hale, and he's fouled out of the game. Steve Hale is out, but what a game for the Jinx Oklahoma Junior. And the only doubt in my mind about Kenny Smith making second team all-conference is the fact that so many votes are going to be split between these teammates, Steve Hale and Kenny Smith. Steve is coming out of the ball game. He'll leave with 13 points, 30 seconds left to play. And he has fouled out of both Duke games this year. And, Henry, that's the fourth game he's fouled out of all season.
Boy, who would have thought at the beginning of the season Steve Hale would have a shot at either of the all-ACC teams? As Dizzy Dean would have said, who would have thunk it?
He's had a great year. Dawkins at the line. He's on my first team all-conference, which I've already voted. Dawkins, his free throw is up and good. That's 24 for Johnny Dawkins. I had Lynn Bias of Maryland, Lorenzo Charles of NC State, Johnny Dawkins of Duke, Mark Allery of Georgia Tech, and Brad Daugherty of North Carolina. Next free throw is good also. That's 25, and Weldon Williams is replacing Dawkins. Dawkins being taken out of the last home game of the season, 78-68, 30 seconds left. This means that Carolina, for a 19th consecutive year, that's remarkable, has won either first or second place in the ACC standing. Shared either one of those positions. Hunter gets through heavy traffic, comes to Peterson, bounces it back out to Kenny Smith. But Mike Krzyzewski taking out a lot of his first team players. Henry, the flag of surrender has been run up from the Duke bench. Now Carolina with 12, 11, 10 seconds. This may be one of the great wins in Carolina history. Right here. Curtis Hunter driving the lane. Back out front to Kenny Smith. 3, 2, 1. It's over. Kenny Smith took it down the lane, and the Tar Heels will finish with a share of first place in the Atlantic Coast Conference standings at 9-5, 22-7 overall. Duke drops into, drops to 8-6, 22-6 overall, and it's possible that if Maryland